It's the home of the Clippers here in Los Angeles as 2K Sports presents our action live from the Staples Center. 2K Sports is proud to present NBA basketball alongside... Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. And it's the Warriors to start out. Now Golden State's starting five. Thompson and Barnes, the two and three. Down low, it's Green and Bogut. And it's Curry in at the point guard. Now here is Bogut on the wing, Thompson. Blake Griffin pulls it in.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Well, you know, the Warriors have been a tough team at home for a while now. But it's in the last few years where they've proven that they can get it done on the road as well.
Green against Paul. Unloads from nine. Tries again. And Griffin with the layup.
That rebound and the follow kind of typify what he's all about. Just gritty, determined play.
And so here is Golden State.
Well, the Warriors did more than hold their own on the road. I mean, they slowly have become one of the best road teams in the league. 24 wins away from Oracle last year.
And a clever pass fake kept the D from closing in.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Ball outside. The dish to Redick. To Paul. Jordan against Bogut. Jordan kicks to Redick. He feeds it to Paul. Jordan sets the pick for Paul. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
A surreal alley-oop that time, partner.
The pass, Clark, the catch, the dunk, all of it perfect.
Precision at its finest.
Man, it all had to be perfect and in precision. That's not nearly as easy as they made it look.
Back on the topic of the Warriors, those 24 wins, Clark, were actually the third most in the entire NBA.
That really is something. Only the Spurs and Thunder won more road games than the Warriors did. And when you get hot like this team can, you can win in any building, and they proved that.
The Clippers have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Pass to Barnes. Green against Griffin. And Draymond Green picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
That's his first personal foul. First team foul.
Barnes, screen on Bogut. 6 on the shot clock. A fadeaway. Good.
It's a pretty good finish to a very shaky offensive possession.
Warriors have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Here's Thompson. Misses off the left iron. Clippers leading by 3. Barnes with it. Guarded now by Andrew Bogut. Always going up for the alley-oop here. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Ball against Curry. Thompson outside. Kicks it to Green. Inside. 6 to shoot. Here's Curry. Tries again. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Nice work to get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. The defense not going to allow many easy layups. They're going to make you earn it from the line.
The Warriors shooting their first foul shots of the night here.
Well, they were 75% free throw shooting a season ago.
Free throw good, Bogut.
Well, you know, every time these two teams face off, it is Battle Los Angeles. For so long, the Lakers have really owned the city. But the Clippers looking to make up for lost time right now.
Jamal Crawford, he's checked in for J.J. Redick. The Warriors also with a sub. Iguodala's checked in. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession.
Boy, just a brain cramp, guys. I mean, that should have been the simplest of exchanges.
A big group substitution here for the Clippers. Spencer Hawes has checked in for Jordan. Davis comes in for Blake Griffin. Hedo Turkoglu's checked in for Barnes. And it's Jared Cunningham in for Paul. Then for the Warriors, Festus Ezeli, he's checked in for Bogut. Spates comes in for Draymond Green. And it's Barbosa in for Steph Curry. Now here's Iguodala. Barbosa dishes to Iguodala. Charity stripe shot, and that one's good. And that ties it up. And a bit of controversy, guys. Last season, Doc Rivers had the Lakers championship banners covered up for Clipper home games.
I thought it was a smart decision, Kevin. I mean, you got to make it your home gym, and all they did was hang up banners of their own players. A smart move by Doc, and you know, the Clippers will forever be in the Lakers' shadow in L.A., regardless of the results of the games.
Davis, a rebound by Ezeli. Golden State's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. The kick out to Spates. Pass to Barnes. Golden State moving the ball around. Shot from 12. It's a big, high bouncing, goes in.
It was almost like he was surprised to be that wide open, yet he knocked it down.
The Clippers have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Crawford with the ball. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. Los Angeles shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
And you look at the numbers, guys, this team shot a 73% clip over the course of last season.
And, you know, there was plenty of blame to go around for that. I mean, it wasn't just one or two guys. I mean, for the most part, the entire team struggled.
And the Warriors making a change here. Livingston's checked in. The Warriors leading. It's Leandro Barbosa on the wing. Spates sets a screen. Barbosa passes to Livingston. From deep, Iguodala. That drops and it comes off the assist from Livingston. Iguodala's got 5 points so far. It'll count. The shot no good. And so the first quarter is in the books. Warriors ahead, leading by 4. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment. All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
Big boost from their bench there, guys, in that first quarter. They did a nice job coming in and really giving this team a lift.
Yeah, it's a nice attribute to have. Firepower coming off the pine early. That's good stuff.
Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. CP3 at point with Redick there at the back. And it's Barnes at the three spot. They're the group out there for the Clippers starting the second quarter. Chris Paul, Clark, the driving force behind the Clippers offense, as good a distributor as he is. He's also been probably, I think, their best crunch time scorer.
Perhaps that's the case, but I think Blake Griffin has made big progress in his scoring game over the last season. More assertive, more skilled, turning and facing, getting to the free throw line, getting better, knocking down free throws as well. And I think that's kind of helped take some of the scoring pressure off of CP3.
A lot of people who watch the NBA really kind of challenged him to expand his game, and he answered the challenge.
No, he did. He stepped up there.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Well, the Clippers backcourt of Chris Paul and J.J. Redick, a great combo. But the two were bitter rivals playing in the ACC, even exchanging blows back in 2004. Redick said, "I knew he didn't like me, and I didn't like him either." Paul said it was their competitive natures that led them to clash. But guys, as teammates, they become good friends.
Yeah, sometimes the players you hate to face make the best teammates. Of course. The Warriors shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
And last season when Chris Paul separated his shoulder and had to miss about a month, I think that was when Griffin really asserted himself. That team kept winning. Really good sign for the Clips.
Curry's checked in for Andre Iguodala. Now here's Paul. Passes it to Redick. Picked by Griffin. Now here's Redick. Not a lot of room. No good from Jordan.
And Chris Paul, despite the injury, won the 2013 Los Angeles Sportsman of the Year Award. He grew up in North Carolina, never figured he'd get so far away from home, but he seems to have settled in nicely on the left post.
Boy, they're fortunate. The defense was taking a big chance leaving him that wide open behind the arc.
He dishes it to Barnes for the three, and again Los Angeles with the triple.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
Dishes it to Bogut, and stolen by Jordan. An even three-on-three break. Here's Paul. Takes it from 10. Again, the Clippers.
Field goal percentage has been bumped up into the high 50s now.
Well, they should be winning, shooting the ball like that. This is a very efficient offense we're seeing out of this club.
And the Warriors decide to take their first timeout here. Barnes is checked in for Sean Livingston. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Bogut sets a screen for Green. Here's Curry with the three. The Clippers grab the miss. Griffin's got 5 rebounds tonight.
Well, the Clippers had really good depth at the guard position, but last season their lack of depth along the front line was a real problem. One they hope has been solved this season.
That's good. And it's 6 points for Chris Paul.
Boy, after having a tough time in the first, he's managed to turn it around nicely this quarter.
Thompson outside. Green with a screen for Thompson to stop the run. That's good. Thompson's got his second basket of the night. And looking at the Clippers bench, maybe the strongest in the NBA 2 seasons ago.
Well, the Bledsoe trade weakened their bench, but it strengthened their starting lineup. But a winning team in Los Angeles with a players coach like Doc Rivers, I mean, you knew they'd be able to find some help.
And here is Paul after the three-pointer from Klay Thompson.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
Yeah, they have the defense on the run right now because every pass seems to have a purpose. They're getting great movement, great spacing, and they're really lining them up defensively.
Here's Thompson following the basket by Chris Paul. Bogut sets a screen for Thompson, feeds it to Bogut. Back to Thompson. Just 5 on the clock. And here's Barnes for 3, and it's the Clippers with the rebound. Griffin's got 6 rebounds now in the game. From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Burke.
Guys, Draymond Green, a second-round pick in 2012, but his tough defense and high basketball IQ have earned him minutes. He said, quote, "I never cared about stats, and I still don't. My goal is to have an impact on the game. Sometimes you have the biggest impact with plays that don't show up in the stats. Those are the plays I live for." Great attitude, Kevin.
A real gamer, Doris. He loves the game. Thanks. Now here's Barnes after the miss from Stephen Curry. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession.
A temporary lapse of focus from him on that turnover. It's embarrassing, but on occasion it does happen.
A platoon swap here for the Clippers. Different look here for the Warriors. Festus Ezeli, he's jacked in for Bogut. Spates comes in for Draymond Green. Andre Iguodala, he's checked in for Thompson. And it's Barbosa in for Steph Curry. Now here is Barbosa. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. The pass to Iguodala. He kicks it to Barnes. Davis with some nice deep.
That was a layup. And you've got to knock that down. You've got to convert when you get those opportunities.
Well, I tell you, that's outstanding determination to track that rebound down and fight his way to the bucket for the throwdown.
Clark, that is the effort they're going to need for the rest of this game.
And not just on the offensive glass, Kevin, but all over the floor.
And the first half ends in a close one. Clippers ahead as they end the second quarter on a 14-6 run. And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Hi, Kevin. I'm here with Chris Paul. And Chris, you've been out-rebounding them and out-shooting them, but it's still a tight game. Why haven't you been able to get more separation?
Hey, right now, we're playing at that tempo. You know, we need to pick up the pace. Defend, rebound, run, and pick up the pace a little bit.
Chris, thank you. Kevin, for this team, the faster, the better.
Thank you for the great interview, Doris. We'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime. We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. You look at Chris Paul, what a contribution.
Well, he created a lot of opportunities for himself in the first couple of quarters. And I'll tell you what, he was smart with his shot making too. Really took good ones.
You know, points per shot attempted is really one of the undervalued stats in the game. And it's a real measurement of efficient scoring.
Los Angeles leading by four, setting the floor for the Warriors. Curry and Thompson, the Splash Brothers, in the backcourt. Barnes and Green, the forward tandem. And it's Bogut, and at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Now, here's Redick. Jordan with a screen on Thompson. And Redick kicks to Jordan. Just three to shoot. Fades back. No good. The Warriors go the other way with it.
Well, when Harrison Barnes first stepped onto the scene, it was in the middle of the Warriors' 2013 playoff run. But he didn't exactly build upon that streak as people were hoping for last year. The playing time just wasn't there.
Here's Barnes. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him.
Great job defending the hoop there.
So important to have good presence defensively inside.
Now here's Barnes. Now the feed to Griffin. There's the dish to Barnes. Back to Griffin. And he finishes nicely on the way. Griffin's got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for the Clippers.
And I remember that run for Barnes. He would play as a stretch four and looked unguardable at times in their series against the Nuggets and then the Spurs. Definitely was hoping for more of that this past season.
Green kicks to Barnes, and he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
Sharp pass to give his teammate the high percentage shot in close.
Clippers leading by four. You know, for Barnes, it was an awkward place for him to be in. They brought in Iguodala, and he was moved to the bench. A lot of people thought that that'd be a boon for him, as he would be more focused on the offensive side of things with that second unit in particular and could really thrive.
Yeah, and the change in role and adjusting to being the first option with the second unit, I think was overwhelming for him. And you know, I think you have to remember Barnes is still a very young player, a lot of room for growth, very talented, very skilled, and he's going to get a lot better. Well, Griffin, a former dunk contest champion, but make no mistake, Blake is a game dunker, always among the league leaders. And at his size, with that strength, the way he gets off the floor is just unbelievable.
Griffin hits them both. You know, Blake Griffin gets up so high, he's created some debate, in fact, on the definition of a dunk. So I'll ask, does your hand have to touch the rim?
You know, I think you don't necessarily have to have your hand touch the rim, Kevin, but you do have to throw it through the goal. None of this raggedy-type dunk stuff.
Got to control it.
Yeah, I like that's the word I was looking for.
Two on the clock. Curry gets the bucket.
Don't take your eyes off of him because he can make plays from multiple spots on the floor. Put the isolated cam on.
Los Angeles leading by three. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Pass to Redick. In the corner, it's Griffin. Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying, Clark, to get back into this game like this.
Yeah, definitely a jam with emphasis. A big apostrophe or exclamation point. How about maybe even a question mark, Mark?
Well, you know what the questions are about now. It's their defense, that's for sure.
Now Redick after the missed three from Klay Thompson. And Redick kicks to Paul. He feeds it to Redick. Back to Paul. Shoots it. The second effort. Jordan kicks to Paul. Redick for three. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Paul's got his third assist on the night.
I like the offensive awareness to exploit that lack of coverage on that play.
Well, everyone knew that the Warriors were going to be a team on the rise after their deep run in 2013. Steve, you saw it firsthand, and they climbed to the ranks of the best in the West in 2014.
Well, they didn't end up where many had hoped, which would have been in the top four of the conference, but they were powerful at times and tough to stop. And in the West, you know, they still finished sixth. It just shows you the depth of the conference.
Al Paul, Harrison Barnes missing on the three. Paul goes in. And they double up Paul. Nobody near Barnes. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Well, as you know, there are polls for just about everything in sports. Last year, Steph Curry was actually voted as the most trustworthy player in the league.
You talked about trust in Steph Curry. It seemed he was able to trust his ankles a bit more last year.
Yeah, that had been a big concern, repeated ankle sprains. Part of the reason the Warriors were able to sign him to such a bargain extension. But when healthy, clearly an all-star and all-league player.
Both teams will make substitutions. And both free throws good for Curry. Well, the Warriors taking strides to enhance their player development. They bought a D-League team and moved it to nearby Santa Cruz.
And that team actually played in the D-League finals in the championship game, lost to Fort Wayne. That's enabled their younger players, though, that D-League team, to practice with the NBA teammates, and that's got to be a positive.
And the shot is good. Crawford's got the lead up to 8 now for Los Angeles.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it didn't work. Not if it results in that shot.
Left side Curry. Good. Curry's got 7 points in the game.
They're not as aggressive from the outside here, but maybe they should think about stretching the defense a little bit, like they did in the first half. I mean, stretching the defense makes it easier to score inside, too.
It's Crawford with the drive. Crawford missing again. Gets it off. The shot is off. The third quarter comes to a close. Clippers lead by 6. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. And how about a look now at our assist of the game, brought to you by State Farm.
This was a showstopper, wasn't it? Just a difficult pass to make, and he makes it flawlessly to set up that alley-oop.
Our fourth quarter action underway, presented by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups. Setting the floor for the Clippers, they've got Hedo Turkoglu, Cunningham is out there with Crawford. Then there's Spencer Hawes, and it's Davis in at the four spot. Here's Crawford following the score by Golden State. And it's Davis at the elbow. Clock at six. A terrific shot on the turnaround. Here is Livingston. It's Leandro Barbosa on the wing. Fourth quarter of basketball. We're about a minute into it. Nice D from Crawford.
Hard work on the glass once again, fellas. They put a lot of effort into their rebound.
Well, you get more rebounds, you get more possessions, more shots at the hoop, and oftentimes that decides the game.
Now here is Davis. It's blocked. Here is Livingston. Kicks it to Azili. Wants to get it to Iguodala and does. And the basket good.
That was the third straight high percentage look this defense has allowed. I mean, these defenders have got to start bumping bodies in the paint. Be more physical. Be more aggressive.
I agree, Clark, but it doesn't look like they have the will to do that at this moment.
Los Angeles calls timeout.
Festus Ezeli missing time last season recovering from his knee surgery. He's trying to regain his form after a rookie season which saw him start 41 games.
A platoon swap here for the Clippers. Different look here for the Warriors. Andrew Bogut checked in for Festus Ezeli. Draymond Green comes in for Maurice Spates. Harrison Barnes, he's checked in for Andre Iguodala. And it's Thompson in for Leandro Barbosa. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Kevin, Doc Rivers was just addressing the plan with his team. He told his team to keep looking for three-point opportunities, saying their perimeter defense isn't doing a good job getting out on our shooters. So let's keep firing away until they decide to guard us.
Now, here's Thompson, following the shot by Chris Paul. It's good, and the Clipper lead is cut to just one on the basket from Thompson.
Ben Ezeli re-injuring his MCL and PCL ligaments toward the end of his rookie season. He first strained that knee in his senior season at Vanderbilt.
Now, here's Redick. No good on the three. And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. Bogut down low, defended by Paul. And that'll be Golden State as it goes out of bounds. Warriors retain possession. And for Ezeli, only 6 years of organized basketball, Clark, prior to even entering the NBA.
Yeah, he's young to the game, and you can see it sometimes in how he plays, but the size and athleticism he possesses are really valuable assets, and I think he's got a chance with work to be a contributing player.
Curry's checked in for the Warriors. Here's Paul. Harrison Barnes picking up that last basket. Paul kicks to Griffin. Left side, Griffin. Jordan inside. Bogut on him. The basket counts and one. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it a three-point play.
You know, that putback's about as easy as it's going to get. You have to put a body on someone down there.
Well, no box out. That's the result you get right there.
Shooting for Los Angeles, DeAndre Jordan. Shooting one.
Free throw good, Jordan.
Oh, and one can be really critical moments in a tight game like this one.
Timeout called the Warriors. They're behind by two. We've got 1:48 left to play here on the fourth. Going to be over and back, not watching for the line that time.
Well, that turnover right there isn't typical of the performance he's turned in today. In fact, that's his only turnover of the game. He's done a really good job taking care of the ball.
Now here's Paul. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Griffin against Green. Leans. That misses. misses off the backboard.
Well, I tell you what, he's going to put a lot of pressure on their perimeter shooters if he can't convert those chances.
Curry dishes to Green. Pass to Thompson. Feeds it to Curry. On the wing, Green. Lock at six. It's Thompson off the drive. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. 59 seconds left in the game. Green against Griffin. It's good!
Well, that's just one make for him in the fourth. I mean, he just hasn't been able to do it for him scoring-wise.
Paul with the steal. And now Paul pushing it up. No one back to stop him. A huge slam. The perfect end of the fast break.
Terrible transition defense there.
I think it would have been pointless, Steve. There was no way anybody was beating him to the basket there.
35 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Time running low here. They need a hoop.
Yeah, score quickly and then foul him right away.
Clippers foul.
And the Clippers call time here. They're up by six. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. He drops the first one, and that brings them within five. And good on the second, so he makes them both. A chance here to possibly put it out of reach.
Now they've got to focus, make sure this is a good, solid possession. They can take control of this game.
Shooting for Los Angeles, J.J. Redick.
Two shots. So the first one drops, and that puts them up by five. So he goes two for two at the line, and it's a six-point ball game.
Good work at the line to stretch that lead out a little bit.
Timeout called the Warriors. They're trailing by six. 27 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Curry against Paul. Curry passes it to Bogut. Back to Curry. And it's good. Pop through contact, gets the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Defender a little hesitant to offer resistance as he bursts to the hoop.
Free throw good by Curry. They foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point.
Well, you do what you have to do to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management, crucial.
He hits the first one, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
Two shots.
So he gets them both, and it's a five-point game.
And that ought to do it. I think any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those free throws.
No good. And an intentional foul right there.
That's his first personal foul, fourth team foul. Shooting for Los Angeles.
So the first one drops, and that increases their lead to six.
At the line number two.
And the second free throw, no good. A tough break there. Thompson from long range hands the three.
And the hot shooting continues, guys.
Yeah, it sure does, Steve. They've mothballed the defense, though. It's all about offense today.
So it's the Clippers taking the win in a close one. It was tight, but they managed to come up with the win.
You know, nobody wants to lose a close game, Kevin. It's much better to win those tight ones.
And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. And now, Jordan presents our player of the game, Blake Griffin.